morning, everyone. My name is Crystal and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you like my videos, please smash that like button. Please do subscribe. I'm here in Rochester in my flat and my cat is at it again. Hurry! No. So we all get up in the morning. The cats get fed, so does the dog, Max. And after my cat is fed, Harry, not so much the older one, he just goes like a maniac. He's trying to stalk the phone now. So every time I do my video, he's up. There he goes, jumping on the phone. Hi, guys. I hope you're going to have a great Tuesday. It's Tuesday. And let's see what today brings. Alexa, good morning.
Good morning. On this day in 1472, the cash-strapped King of Norway pawned the Orkney and Shetland Islands to the King of Scotland as security for a dowry he was unable to pay. What the residents of the islands had to say on the matter is not known, but I suspect they were unimpressed.
Alexa, what's the time, please?
Good morning, Crystal. It's 7:32 a.m.
Alexa, what's the date today?
It's Tuesday, the 20th of February.
Alexa, what's the weather like?
Currently, in Rochester it's 6 degrees Celsius with mostly cloudy skies. Today, you can expect overcast weather, with a high of 13 degrees and a low of 6 degrees.
Alexa, can you tell me a joke?
Why shouldn't you tell a joke to an egg? Because it might crack up.
Alexa, whose birthday is it today?
Today's famous birthdays include American actress and singer Olivia Rodrigo, Barbadian singer, fashion designer, actress, and businesswoman Rihanna, United States Senator from Kentucky Mitch McConnell, South African comedian and television host Trevor Noah, and American actor Miles Teller.
So, good morning, guys. Today at 8 o'clock, I'm expecting a triage call from the doctor's surgery in Strood. They assess your symptoms over the phone and see whether you need to come into the doctor's or not. Or whether they could just medicate you or sort you out over the phone. So 8 o'clock, we have a triage call from my doctor's surgery. So, these walls aren't soundproof. Neither is the ceiling. So this morning I got woken up at, oh, it must have been just after 5 o'clock in the morning, because the guy upstairs goes to work early. I think he does shift work. He's not a postman, he does shift work, I think. I don't know. Well, so, you know, whenever he wakes up, I wake up, because he's got heavy feet. He's a large guy and you can hear him get up in the morning right above my ceiling in the bedroom. So he got up about 5 o'clock in the morning. He's gone to work and you know, you just hear the usual noises, kids going off to school, woo 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 woo, up the street, usual. Somebody beat their horn about half an hour ago. They beat their horn, like the, sometimes when the guy upstairs has his kids to stay, someone beeps the car horn. So about half an hour ago we had a car horn beep. Oh, my cats, no, Harry, no. Every time he's fed, he just is darting towards the camera. So yeah, I got woken up at 5 o'clock this morning. Well, I had to get up early anyway because I've got a phone call to make. I've also got to look up homes to bid on because I need to get out of here. It's making my life a misery. I need to de-stress. I keep getting stressed out. I'm not a young woman. And it's just stressing me out. I'm not a bloke either, but I know why, you know, they think blokes are, some blokes are, you know, are normal, they have feelings too. Blokes get upset, blokes cry. So you shouldn't be doing it to anyone, whoever you are, trying to upset somebody, whoever you're trying to upset. So like I said, it's Tuesday morning. I'm waiting for a call from my doctor's surgery, the triage clinician. I'm supposed to go back to the doctors as well for about my feet. Just the sprained ankle now. With my foot, the ankle seems to have healed, but where I've been pressing apparently on my other foot, the ball of my foot is in agony. I don't know what's going on with my feet. It's the menopause. You get all sorts of symptoms, all sorts of feelings, and it can go on for several years. It's the latest stage in a woman's life, and you've just got to get used to it. It is horrendous. It can be for some women, and it is horrible for some women. It's painful, the mood swings that you cannot control. Whatever medication I take, I cannot control it. I'm trying to deal with bullies as well, which is terrible. I mean, there was someone coughing underneath my window this morning. Like the guy upstairs, I've been writing it in my diary for the past 3 years. I want to get out of this. I want to move somewhere, start afresh, and just forget this crap ever happened, to be fair. You know, I don't want to be controlled by people. I'm my own person. I don't want to be cross. I don't want to be angry. I just want to live my life. But I've always got someone either coughing behind my back, coughing outside near my balcony, or in shops when I'm trying to shop. In shops, supermarkets, when you're shopping for food, people coughing right behind your back or near you, near the food. I mean, I remember, who wants to be a millionaire? I don't think I'm crazy, because years ago, who wants to be a millionaire? People in the audience were coughing to signify the answers to questions to the contestant. So coughing can be deliberate. It can be done on purpose. It can. I also believe in hypnotism. And you don't have to, I don't believe in the hypnotism where the pendulum puts you to sleep, you know, up and down, up and down. I believe in noises and sight. Hypnotizing people with symbols on clothes and colours and noises in the background when you're on a phone call and what people are saying in a phone conversation. Trigger words. So when if someone says, see you later, and then all of a sudden you come over really, really cross and angry for no reason. So I believe that you can be hypnotized over the phone, and I believe there are trigger words that can set somebody off, and in worst case scenarios you can get somebody to cause harm to somebody by hypnotism. You also can make people feel that they're in a tremendous amount of pain when they're not, but they actually feel that pain. So I believe in hypnotism. And it can be used for the bad, for wrong reasons. And you don't have to be hypnotized by pendulums and someone hypnotizing you like that. Right, my WhatsApp went off yesterday, 19 to the dozen. I'm just going to get my iPhone, my WhatsApp. Sending me grainy photographs, they said. Grainy photos of themselves. I'm just going to check out my other phone that I keep in the bedroom. So, my mum called at 7:31 a.m. It's 7:41. I'm up and ready to go. Has my WhatsApp gone off? Just check the WhatsApp. Hear the train whistle. Yes, this place is extremely noisy. I've just heard the train whistle go off. I stopped WhatsApping somebody last night at 5:54. They said they were on their bike ready to drop a groom off. So they were taking a groom for a ride on the bike to the wedding. I doubt very, very much that's the real person and that's their real photographs. But if they want to convince themselves that I believe what they're saying and I believe they're in those photographs, they're wrong. But if it keeps them occupied and it keeps this harasser away from other people, that's great. I don't believe they're all there in the head at all. Apparently, they ride a bike, a motorbike. They were dropping a groom off at a wedding yesterday, and they're a postman, and they get up very early in the morning. Well, so does he upstairs. He got up at 5 this morning, and he's not a postman. Alexa, LBC Radio.
LBC London from Global Player.
The liberal democracies of the West have to distinguish themselves from
Putin's Russia.
From Putin's Russia, and Julian is at grave risk of ending up like Navalny.
Now, Mr. Assange is requested to appear in court in person. It's expected, though, he will appear via a video link from Belmarsh Jail in Woolwich, South East London. We're fortunate to be able to turn to Nick Vamos, who's former head of extradition at the CPS, the Crown Prosecution Service, now head of business crime at the firm Peters & Peters, joins me now. Thanks for coming on, Mr. Vamos. What will this turn on in your view? Good morning.
Good morning. When Mr. Assange applied for leave to appeal in writing, the judge dismissed all of his arguments very quickly. He now has 2 days to renew those arguments in person through his barristers. And their main argument is the one that his wife has just articulated, that these are political offences, he's being pursued for his political beliefs, and also that essentially what he's accused of is journalism rather than espionage.
And which, when it comes to this specific case, this will be the final hearing?
It potentially is the final hearing. It's a bit of a game of stakes and ladders. So if he is denied leave to appeal, that's it in the UK. His only recourse then is to go to Strasbourg and ask for an emergency declaration, interim relief it's called, saying that he can't be removed from the UK while they consider his case. I don't think they would grant that, although I'm sure he would try. If he's given leave to appeal, then it will get put off again for a substantive appeal hearing in maybe a month or so.
Why has it taken so long?
Well, partly because he hid in the Ecuadorian embassy for many years, and therefore nothing could happen while he was there. And also because our legal system allows each side to appeal, and unfortunately, in extradition cases, those appeals happen consecutively rather than all together in one big hearing, which probably would have been a bit simpler. So, first of all, his extradition was denied, and the Americans were allowed to appeal, and they succeeded, and that went to the door of the Supreme Court, who said they wouldn't hear it. And then we go all the way back down the snake, and he gets his appeal, and that's where we are at the moment. So it's a combination of factors.
Lastly, his legal team say if convicted of the US charges, he could look at a jail term there of up to 175 years. From your position, does that seem fair, or is that slightly over-egging it?
That's nonsense, and I'll tell you why. That's the theoretical position. But the US have given a diplomatic undertaking to the UK court and the UK government that if he's convicted, he can be transferred immediately to serve his sentence in Australia. And given the diplomatic support that the Australians have been giving him recently, I think he will be freed the minute his plane hits the tarmac in Australia. They will commute his sentence, which they're allowed to do under the convention where prisoners are transferred, and he won't serve a day in prison. So this idea that he's going to die in a US prison, I'm afraid, is complete nonsense.
Strong words, and I'm grateful for your candor. Nick Vamos, thank you. You're head of business crime at Peters & Peters, firm of solicitors. You were head of extradition at the Crown Prosecution Service. Coming up after the news, water bosses in England and Wales will face bonus bans for illegal sewage discharges. You'll hear from the relevant government secretary of state on that. And in other news... statue of the Jewish singer Amy Winehouse has the Star of David pendant defaced with a sticker of the Palestinian flag. Officials in the Home Office deface a Jewish baby's document and scribble out the word Israel. How tough is it to be Jewish in this country at this time? 7:46 LBC News headlines. Thomas Watts.
The body of Alexei Navalny is still being held by Russian officials who may not release it for 2 weeks. The Home Office has started an investigation after a birth certificate was returned with the word Israel crossed out. And Rishi Sunak will outline support for British farmers in a speech to the NFU conference later. LBC weather, rain across northern and western areas, largely dry elsewhere, a high of 13 degrees.
LBC Travel, I'm Joanne, where the M20 is closed in both directions between junctions 2 at Rootham and 3 at the M26. It's because of an ongoing investigation and there are delays on the approach. Also delays on the M25 clockwise up to junction 5 at the M26. That was after an accident. And the M3 remains very slow northbound to junction 4 at Camberley, and that's also down to an accident where one lane is closed for recovery. Severe delays continue on the A2 westbound to the Falconwood interchange, and that's because a lorry has broken down. And on the underground, there are minor delays on the Central and Circle lines. And Metropolitan line trains aren't stopping southbound at Preston Road and at Northwick Park Station. And that's all down to a track problem.
This is LBC. This is the sound of Jewel Swap.
Right, guys, I'm just going to play my mother's answer phone message to me this morning before the doctor rings. I'm going to try to.
Welcome to your EE voicemail. You have 4 new messages and 2 saved messages. First, new message. Received yesterday at 7:26 a.m. Your message will be saved for 7 days. Next new message. Received yesterday at 1:54 a.m. PM. Hello, this is an important message from Barclays for Miss Crystal Marshall to help us prevent fraud. This is not a marketing or sales call. It's important you respond to this message. Please call our 24-hour automated service at Barclays Fraud Department on 0333202743 as soon as possible. The number again is 0333202743. If you are calling from abroad, please call 02036083999. Thank you. Goodbye. To return the call at your normal call rate, press hash. Your message will be saved for 7 days. Next new message. Received yesterday at 7:26 p.m.
Good evening, Janessa. This is your mother, Jen.
Message deleted. Next new message. Received today at 7:31 a.m.
Good morning, Janessa. This Tuesday morning. Can I just say, I hope you get all right at the doctor's today. I rang you a little bit early just to let you know that I'm thinking of you and give me a ring with the result or whatever when you can. Also, Janessa, Have a lovely day. Okay, Janessa. Bye for now. Thinking of you.
Message deleted.
Well, I'll be having a talk with the doctor this morning. We'll see what happens over the phone. Because my mum has just keep mentioning my doctor's appointment every day for about 4 days, which does upset me and it makes me nervous as to what's going to happen outside this afternoon. So, you know, I'm not cross, I'm not angry, I'm expecting a phone call and we see what happens. Also, somebody has been trying to take money out of my bank account and Barclays are ringing me in case it's fraud. Fraud. I did tell you, I don't tell lies. Barclays Bank want me to ring them back because someone's been trying to take money out of my account without my permission. See you later.